What's up, guys? Josiah here with EasyCaters.com. Today I'm going to do a video on how to identify or find option symbols that have low bid-ask spreads. Now, spoiler alert, Thinkorswim does not actually provide a way to directly scan for low bid-ask spreads. So the thing is, we have to come up with some, you know, clever workarounds or ways to identify those options without actually having the ability to, you know, go into the stock hacker or option hacker and select the filter for low bid ask spread. That doesn't exist. So we have to come up with other ways to do that. And so this video is just going to cover some ideas about how to identify those options and show you a way to set up a scan that will look for those options. So when we're looking at options with a low bid ask spread, we're really talking about liquidity. The more liquidity, the lower the bid ask spread in general. So there are lots of different things that go into making a symbol more liquid. So one thing is going to be how liquid is the underlying stock. If the underlying stock is highly liquid, then it's more likely that the option is going to be highly liquid. So what we can do is reduce the option symbols that we look at to only options on those stocks that are that we can identify as being more likely to be liquid. we can identify that in a couple of ways. One way is saying, okay, average daily volume of the stock needs to be X number of shares. We can also, one thing that most people don't realize is you can look at average per minute volume of the stock intraday and make sure that, you know, we're consistently every minute doing a lot of shares. So then we can look for the truly liquid stocks and only look at the options on those stocks. So, and the other thing is price. To me, it seems that the people that are trading options are really looking for the leverage that it provides. So, you know, instead of devoting your whole account balance to one position in an equity that's a really high priced equity, you can buy the option on that stock and preserve your buying power for other positions and get that leverage. So to me, it seems that it makes sense that there would be more liquidity in the higher priced stock options. So we can look for stocks that are higher priced or at least above a minimum threshold, just to make sure we're not looking, you know, because it wouldn't necessarily make as much sense to trade options on a penny stock or something like that. So we'll just set a minimum threshold for the stock price, minimum thresholds for the stock volume, average daily volume, and the average per minute volume. And then we can look at some factors for the option itself. We can say, if you look here at this chart, for instance, now this is a chart of an actual option symbol, not the stock itself. And a lot of people don't know that you can chart those option symbols on the price graph. To do that, you just go to whatever stock it is that you want to trade and an option on, and go pull up the option chain, right click on the option, and copy that option symbol, and then just go paste it over here into the symbol selector, and there you go. So And also, after you create an option scan, you can pull that scan up on your sidebar. And so the symbols that it pulls up will be option symbols that then you can just click on and it will automatically pull that up. So you don't have to copy and paste them like I just did. But so those are two methods for pulling up option symbols on your chart. But I was trying to illustrate with that last couple of symbols ago that I had on here that the closer you get to expiration, generally speaking, the more liquid the option is going to be. options to begin their lives as, you know, pretty thinly traded, as you can kind of see over here on this symbol. It's really spotty trading activity here. But then as we get closer and closer to expiration, it starts getting more thickly traded and a lot more liquidity comes in. So that's one thing we can look for at on the option, is we can say, okay, well, we're not going to look at options that are more than X number of days away from expiration. So we could say 90 days is a maximum or something like that. And another item that we can look at is the open interest. Open interest, the larger the open interest, the more eyes are on that option symbol. And so the likelihood is that there's going to be more liquidity there and a lower bid-ask spread. And of course, the option volume itself is another key way of identifying whether or not there's some liquidity there to be had. If there's a lot of volume being traded, then that probably indicates that there is some liquidity and a low bid-ask spread. Or at least the possibility of a low bid-ask spread there. So those are all ways that we can look for this. So if you look here, I'm in Stock Hacker. You can use Option Hacker. They're actually, as far as I know, they're exactly the same thing. Option Hacker just has the word option in front of it instead of stock. Otherwise, I have not found any difference in functionality between the two. So create a scan in either one. You can see all the same buttons are up here at the top for adding those different filters in Stock Hacker as it is in Volume Hacker, in Option Hacker. So just pick one and go with it. So here in Stock Hacker, you can see I've got a scan preset already pre-filled for us here. And so I'm going to walk through each element and go over how it applies. So first I'm scanning in the universe of all symbols, and I've got that intersected with all optionable. So that's going to it's going to intersect those two lists and run the scan against only the resulting list of that intersection. And then down here in the bottom, you'll notice I've got it looking for all stock and option symbols, both, not just stocks, not just options, but I've got it looking for stocks and options. And you want to set a number here that makes sense. Too big and it will use up a lot of system resources and take a long time to run the scan. And of course, too small, you'll have too few results. So first of all, I've got it scanning for some stock criteria here. So you can add a filter for stock up here at the top. And I've set this to closing price greater than 20. So again, we're looking for underlying securities that are just at least some minimum price, so that it's more likely that more option traders will be trading on that option. And it's just not as likely that there are going to be a lot of options traders trading on an option of a penny stock or something like that. So I just put a minimum price threshold here. You can choose whatever you want. Then I've got some study filters, and these study filters only apply to stocks, to the underlying stock. Study filters can't apply to the option symbol currently in Thinkorswim. I don't know why they've set it up that way, but that's how it works. So basically for the stock, I'm looking for average daily volume on a long-term basis, 50 periods, of greater than 1 million shares per day. And then on a short-term basis, I'm looking for the 10-day average volume of greater than 1 million shares. Then I've got another unique one here that I think a lot of people don't realize you can do, which is a 10-period average per minute volume of 1,000 shares or greater. So it's saying it's running an intraday volume average and looking for stocks that have at least 1,000 shares per 1 minute bar being traded on average. And you can set that however you want. But so this is going to look for really liquid stocks that are, you know, pretty easily day tradable and that kind of thing. And so these stocks are likely to have a smaller bid-ask spread than the average stock. So then we're going to look for the actual options on this stock. And to do that, we're going to add some option filters here with this button. So I've set this option filter to days to expiration, like we had said. I want it to be a minimum of 5, so we'll have a few days left to expiration, just for the purposes of this video. And then maximum of, we'll say, 90 days. So, you know, the farther out from expiration we get, like I said, the less liquidity is there. So just cap it off at some maximum amount that you're comfortable with and that you find works best for you, and then run the scan based on that. And then we're looking for option volume here. And so this volume applies only to the current day. So if you run the scan with a large number here first thing in the morning, then it's not going to return very many results because in the morning, not a lot of contracts have traded yet. But if you run it in the afternoon, a large number might make sense there. So you just remember that this is sensitive to the time of day that you run the scan. So I'm just going to put 100 here. I am later in the afternoon, so you know, so it doesn't matter as much for me. But just keep that in mind as far as the time of day. Then open interest, we'll just put 1,000 here. This could be whatever you want it to be, and different options will need to be different levels. But you know, a minimum open interest will ensure that there are a certain number of eyes that are watching the option symbol, watching the stock symbol, and make sure that there's more likely to be some liquidity there. And then if you want, you can specify an option type, either a call or a put, if you only trade one side or the other. And that can cut the number of results in half so you don't have to sift through so many. And then we'll just run the scan and see what we find. And I'm going to save this. And when I save it, that allows me to pull it up as a scan on the sidebar here by clicking the name here and pulling it up in my list of personal scans. But you can see here, so it's showing 200 of 2,400 possible results. And so if you get a lot here, you might want to make these even more specific, more stringent, or you know, set higher thresholds for the options so that you reduce down that number to only the very best of the best. So you can look at how many the outer figure is here and gauge whether or not you need to make this a little more stringent, some higher thresholds for the options to have to jump over. And so now I've pulled this scan up on the sidebar. And we can sort this by the symbol, or so if you click the symbol column header, you'll notice that it will show the stock symbol, so you can click that to pull up the stock, and then you can pull up the individual options that are associated with that stock, and then you can move on to the next stock, and then the options that are associated with that. And you can see these are pulling up stocks that appear to be trading pretty thickly. And so there you go. So this allows you to both sort them by the underlying symbol, so you can easily pull up the stock. And then, you know, without having to type or anything, you can just click. And then you can switch to the option symbols that are associated with that symbol. And go from there and just kind of go down your list and find the one that you want to trade. And adding like a volume column here can help you see what how much volume each of the options has done for the day and how much volume the stock has done, of course. So that's how you do that. And then one other note, so I have a premium bid ask spread indicator set on my website, which includes this column here that will allow you to sort your list from minimum spread to maximum spread. So you can actually use this column to sort the lowest spread items up to the top of the list. And that way you can, if you have a lot of results, you can sort it that way to bring the the most liquid, the lowest spread, that kind of thing, up to your top, the top of your list. So if you're interested in getting your hands on that, that's at easycaters.com. And what this does essentially, so I have a couple of scripts included in that set, but the column itself will show the spread and highlight at different thresholds that you specify, you know, warning levels essentially saying, okay, this spread is too wide for me to trade, this spread is okay for me to trade, and so forth. So you can set those levels as needed, or you can make it an automatic threshold based on the average true range of the symbol that you're trading. So either one of those modes is available for the column. So hopefully this has been helpful. Like I said, the items we went over were, you know, looking at the liquidity of the stock itself, you know, in terms of volume per day, volume per minute on an average basis to make sure that there's, you know, the stock is doing a lot of volume consistently. Minimum price thresholds for the stock. And then regarding the options itself, since we can't scan directly for the bid-ask spread, we can look for, you know, maximum days to expiration. We can look for minimum open interest. We can look for minimum volume on the day. We can't look for average volume on stocks because they don't allow those study filters to be added for options. They don't allow the study filters to be added to option symbols. But we can look at the absolute volume that has happened already today and say, okay, we only want to trade options that have done such and such, you know, whatever threshold you set for that. So those are the ways that you can scan for these, and then you can use that column to then sort your results to bring the lowest spreads to the top of your list so you can quickly go through those and find ones that are ideal for trading. So hopefully this has helped. If you found any value in the video, please give me a subscribe and a thumbs up below. If you have any questions, leave me a comment down below as well. And be sure to check us out at easycaters.com. And you can get in contact with us there if you have any questions as well. All right. Till next time, we'll talk to you later.